Hi. Today's how-to tutorial is how to import file in InDesign CS5. There are several ways to import files into InDesign CS5. We'll show you a few of them today and a couple advanced tricks for tricky types of file formats. Alrighty then, let's get started on how to import file in Adobe InDesign CS5. For that matter, also CS5.5 and even CS5. Alright, so I've made a new document here, which is quite easy. Just go File, New Document, and we can make a print or web document. I'll stick with print for now. Web is exactly the same, more or less. How can we import a file into InDesign CS5? Under File, there is also Import Options. One of them is to import XML. Another way to import a file into InDesign CS5, particularly an image, is to simply do a Command-D on the Macintosh or place the file. We can select a file, choose Open, and click where we want that file in our document. We saw a fox this day run across right here. Another neat way is place from Buzzword. Buzzword is Adobe's new online document sharing and editing system. Many people ask, when starting this how to import file into Adobe InDesign CS5, is how do you simply get a Word document in here? How do you get the text from a Word file into Adobe InDesign CS5? Well, it's actually quite easy. You just go here and create a text box. Most of us know how to do. And we go over here and we grab a Word document here. You know, we just got a Word file here. We're just going to drag and drop it into that text box. And watch this. It just all pops right over. No need to open it and do all this other fancy-dancy stuff. It just comes on right on over in. That's a real handy tip to get a file into InDesign CS5, in this case a Word file. But there's more. How can I get a Quark file into InDesign? Well, that's where the Markzware menu item, which shows up here, comes into play. How can you get a Quark file into InDesign CS5? It's quite easy with Markzware's Q to
ID. There you'll see this video.
You simply go up to the Markzware menu item and choose Convert Quark File or Convert QuarkXPress Document. It's that easy. Another way to import a file into InDesign CS5 is to go to Edit and Paste in Place. The way you do that is you go into, for instance, an image like this image here, you select all, you edit, copy that image, and you go back into your InDesign file and you click Edit, Paste in Place. And you go in and add that image where you like to. Very handy. You can also copy and then paste text into a document as well. So that's how to import a file in InDesign CS5. Just a few ways how you can import files into InDesign CS5. Markzware also has a Pub to ID importer as well, which is Microsoft Publisher right into InDesign. Very handy. That was the how-to tutorial for today. Hope you enjoyed it. David Dilling from Markzware, signing off.